Hi, I'm Steve Jones. I'd like to talk about the number systems which have been invented or have developed, should we say. First of all, in the past, we have had many systems for counting and for adding and subtracting, which are to do with practical things. For example, lengths, like inches, feet, yards, miles, or weights, pounds, stones, hundredweights. Now, you people in the modern world will not remember these weights because, of course, we don't use them anymore. But these were not easy systems because the system of pounds to stones, how many pounds were there in a stone? 14 pounds in a stone. How many stones in a hundredweight? Does it really matter? The answer is no, but it wasn't simple. And we've got 12 inches in a foot, we've got 3 feet in a yard, and we've got 1,760 yards in a mile. But who really cares? Well, the people who have to do it care. And therefore, we had to invent systems which were more consistent and easier to use. And the obvious one was to the base 10, the decimal system. So the decimal number system has been in use now at least 500 years, and probably before that by quite a lot of people. In the 20th century, we started to use computers a lot more. And computers have a huge advantage that they can calculate. They're very powerful. But they don't like decimal systems. They like binary systems. But the trouble is, human beings don't like binary systems. They like systems like decimal systems with numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have a compromise. We have a hexadecimal system. And this gives us numbers which include the digits 0 to 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then we have some more digits we call A, B, C, D, E, F. So we'll have a number 6CF4, which to us as human beings looks like a strange number, but a computer's very happy with that number because that number relates easily to binary and it understands binary. So we have now a system which is a modern system invented in the 20th century, which will suit both people and will suit a computer.